putting your hope in the right place. In fact, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted, while evildoers and impostors will go from bad to worse, deceiving and being deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learned it, and how from infancy you have known the Holy Scripture, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. Jesus, I place my ultimate hope in you today. Show me where I am trusting in things of this world, things that cannot and will not serve me, rather than scientists, doctors, politicians, or anything else. I transfer my trust into you in all things. I worship you as my rock and my redeemer. Amen, hallelujah, amen. Does what works really work? Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, you offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. You do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. For by the grace given me, I say to everyone, to you of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the faith God has distributed to each of you. Holy Spirit, I believe that you are in me and ready to live through me. I refuse to live by what works rather than by you. I don't want to be conformed to the world. I present myself to God as an instrument of worship instead, a living sacrifice by His grace through faith. Amen. Are you ready for His return? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of arms, with 10,000 rivers of oil? Shall I offer my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has showed you, O man, what is good, and what does the Lord require of you? You act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God. Heavenly Father God, I thank you again for the truth of your word. Thank you for the power of your Holy Spirit within me. I thank you that I have been crucified with Christ and He now lives in me. I ask that you continue to reveal the lies that lurk beneath the surface of my thoughts. You have shown me what is good and what is required. I submit to the power of your Holy Spirit in me right now, and I ask that He would live through me the kind of life that you have called me to today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you ready for His return? Therefore, keep watch. because you do not know on what day your Lord will come. But understand this, if the owner of the house had known at what time of night the thief was coming, he would have kept watch and would not have let his house be broken into. So you also must be ready, because the Son of Man will come at an hour when you do not expect me. May your Holy Spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Jesus, my beloved Jesus, thank you that in you I will be found blameless when you return. Give me a consistent perspective that looks to that day more so than today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Your guidelines for powerful daily living. My God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will do it. Heavenly Father God, you are the one at work in us. By your Spirit, through your word, I ask that you will speak to me clearly now. What specific things do you want to do through me to be helpful today? Lead me, guide me. I trust you to do it through me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Your key to great marriage and life. You, my brothers and sisters, were called to be free, but not do not use your freedom to indulge the flesh. Rather, serve one another humbly in love, for the entire law is fulfilled in keeping this one command: love your neighbor and as yourself. If you bite and devour each other, watch out, or you will be destroyed by each other. God, I believe in the truth of your word in principle. Now make it practical. I ask that in the days ahead you will open up your word, and that you will open up my mind to understand and to be willing to walk in your spirit in order to love those around me with all the intensity and purity that you intended. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. How to turn your pain into gain. We also glory in our suffering, because we know that suffering produces perseverance, character, and character hope. Jesus, be my strength and patience in my marriage and all relationships. Use every difficulty I face to draw me into deeper intimacy with you. Show me what I can learn from these hard times. Make me more like Jesus because of them. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen.